This holy man fought to the death for the law of his God and did not fear the words of the godless, for he was built on solid rock. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
May the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We celebrate today the feast of Saint Apollinaris, bishop and martyr. Tradition tells us that he was sent by Saint Peter himself to be the bishop of Ravenna, where he labored most of his life, if not all of his life, and converted many people to the faith. He died as a martyr, and we remember him this day. As we gather, let us be grateful to God for the blessings of faith that brings us together. As we encounter Jesus among us in his word and sacrament, and seek the Lord's blessing and forgiveness of our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Direct your faithful Lord in the way of eternal salvation, which the Bishop St. Apollinaris showed by his teaching and martyrdom, and grant through his intercession that we may so persevere in keeping your commandments as to merit being crowned with him. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Hear what the Lord says. Arise, present your plea before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear, O mountains, the plea of the Lord. Pay attention, O foundations of the earth. For the Lord has a plea against his people, and he enters into trial with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you? Or have I wearied you? Answer me. For I brought you up from the land of Egypt. From the place of slavery, I released you, and I sent Moses before you, Aaron and Miriam. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow before God Most High? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams and myriad streams of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my crime, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? You have been told, O man, what is good and what the Lord requires of you, only to do right and to love goodness and to walk humbly with your God. The word of the Lord. The responsorial. To the upright, I will show the saving power of God. Gather my faithful ones before me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice, and the heavens proclaim his justice, for God himself is the judge. To the upright, I will show the saving power of God. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold. To the upright. Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you? To the upright. Saving power of God. When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Some of the scribes and Pharisees said to Jesus, "Teacher, we wish to see a sign from you." He said to them in reply, "An evil and unfaithful generation seeks a sign, but no sign will be given it except the sign of Jonah, the prophet. Just as Jonah was in the belly of the whale for 3 days and three nights, so will the Son of Man be in the heart of the earth 3 days and three nights. At the judgment, men of Nineveh will arise with this generation to condemn it, because they repented at the preaching of Jonah. But there is something greater than Jonah here. At the judgment, the queen of the south will rise with this generation and condemn it, because she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon. And there is something greater than Solomon here." The Gospel of the Lord. One of the things I like to do in time of rest and relaxation is to play those games on the internet. You know, Words with Friends. I'm sure some of you play that. And it's sometimes it's a struggle to beat somebody, especially somebody you know very well. My niece's husband always beats me. And I often wondered why. I mean, he never went to college, you know. He's a very smart boy, though. But he's just so good. And when I have the chance to get ahead in a particular game, sure enough, the last word or so, he comes through, and he wins. And it's very frustrating. So I said to him one time, "John, you're really great at this game. You know, you really know your words. How do you do it?" He said, "Well, your brother used to play with me, but he stopped because I'm always beating him." I said, "Well, I'm not going to stop. But how do you do it?" He goes, "Well, you know, you work at it. You try this, you try that. And sometimes it's luck. And sometimes, you know, you just do the right thing." So a couple of weeks later, I was looking at the computer game, and I saw all these little knobs and all these little ways of doing whatever, I don't know. So I began going to them, and sure enough, there was one little knob they called hint. It gives you a hint. I said, "Oh, that's how he does it. He's smart enough to know what this little symbol means. He saw the sign, and he was able to continue to beat me. Well, now I found the sign." And so it's a little more competitive. And sometimes I beat him more times than I used to. We got to see the signs. We want to win at life. And God sends constant signs to us. God is always at work with us in this world, as we prayed in our morning prayer today. We have to open our eyes and open our hearts to see those signs if we want to win the game of life. And sometimes we see them and we ignore them, or we see them and we don't understand them. There's so much going on in our world today. We know that. It's not the world you and I grew up in, is it? When things were so different. So many challenges today. So many crises. So much unrest. So much fear. And yet God is working through all this mess. And God sent signs to us again and again and again. But do we see the signs? Are we aware that God is with us? I read this morning where the Felician sisters lost 13 elderly sisters to the virus recently. out of a community of maybe 50, 13 died in Livonia, Michigan. And one of the sisters said, it's been difficult. We couldn't celebrate their life because we're in quarantine, and it's hard, but we know they're with God, and they fulfilled their mission, and their work was done, and we have no regrets. There was no complaining. There was no challenging to God, simply accepting. And they saw these as a signs of God calling people home. Their time has come. We have a great Holy Father. And many times God uses people as signs, as God did the prophet Micah in today's first reading, as God did St. Apollonius, whom we honor today, who was a prophet and spread the good news of Jesus for many years until finally his enemies put him to death for the sake of Jesus. Today, the United States mourns the death of John Lewis. He was a prophet. He put his head on the block, did he not, for what he believed in, justice and civil rights. There's so much going on in our life. But we have a man named Francis who calls us to task so often about keeping the environment clean. We have scientists reminding us how we can get through this crisis. Many people ignore them. We have people speaking up for the poor, and nobody's listening sometimes. There are those speaking up for human rights, especially against sexual people who use other people in trafficking just for their own greed and gain. But they're prophets that are speaking out and challenging and calling people to turn their lives around. They're people who are giving their total energy and effort to make things right in this world where so many things are wrong. Are we listening? Do we see in them God speaking to us, God speaking through them for us, God calling us to see the signs of the times, to listen to the prophets among us, to have an open heart? As Jesus said in yesterday's gospel, if you have ears to hear, you should hear. The prophet Micah got a little tired with the failures of his contemporaries, reminding them that God truly is blessing them with so much freedom and prosperity. God has treated us so well. And God calls us in simply to see the signs, especially through the voices of the prophets among us. God asks so little from us. And all God is asking us to respond. Micah says it well, as we heard in the final reading, the final words of the first reading. This is what God requires of you. Only to do right. Always do the right thing. Hear the prophets. See the signs. To love goodness. That's the only way to overcome evil. That's the only way to deal with the threats that are around us. And most especially, to walk humbly before God. To realize that we don't have all the answers to all the problems. We don't know what's in store for us for the future. but we know who holds the future. We are servants of the Lord. So unlike the people in the times of Jesus who didn't see the signs, Micah calls us today not only to see the signs, but to live by the signs. And now offer our prayers to our Heavenly Father. Let us be ever confident that God hears our every prayer. We pray for all the members of our church. May God strengthen, protect us, and help us realize we are servants of the Lord. We pray to the Lord. For all those people who need God today, may those who are seeking justice and peace, may God bless them with signs that lead them to have that peace. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the elimination of all disease, that this virus that we're dealing with now may be given a cure, and all those afflicted with this pandemic may really feel God's comfort and healing through those who minister to them. We pray to the Lord. For ourselves and all the members of our parish community, as we gather together in prayer this morning, let us realize God is speaking to us. May we open our hearts and our ears to hear where God is leading us, even in the midst of all these trials that we have to endure. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, and today we pray especially for Paul Frailer, for whom we offer this Mass. For all our dear ones who have gone to the other side of life. For all the victims of the pandemic who will die today, may God give them all eternal peace. We pray to the Lord. We pause now to pray for those special needs in our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we come together today to offer our prayers to you, knowing that you will bless us and hear the prayers that we offer to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ. He humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask that you receive us. Be pleased with this sacrifice. We offer you, Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord bless you.
Sanctify our offerings by your blessing, O Lord, we pray. And by your grace, may we be set afire with that flame of your love through which St. Apollinaris overcame every bodily torment and trial. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We give you all to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks through Jesus Christ, our Lord. For the blood of your blessed martyr, St. Apollinaris, poured out like Christ's to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you on earth, and before you without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with St. Apollinaris, whom we honor today, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We pray now as Jesus taught us to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
you. We offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Let us pray. May these holy mysteries of which we have partaken, O Lord, we pray, give us that determination which made your blessed martyr, Saint Apollinarius, faithful in your service and victorious in his suffering. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended now. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day.
Have a great day, Father.